What's up, Internet? Matagal na akong mahilig sa computer. Pero sa video na to, pag-usapan natin 5 different things na nung nalaman ko, nagulat talaga ako. Some of them are random, some of them are pretty basic actually. But all of them, nung nalaman ko sila, parang napaisip ako na, pucha, ganun pala yun. Bonus information, kailangan mo malaman yung product ng sponsor natin because they offer something called unbreakable internet.
Usong-uso ngayon yung mga work from home meetings, making business connections, lahat yun online na ngayon. Ang problema, di mo maasahan yung internet. Kaya para iwas sakit sa ulo at matuloy ang asenso sa negosyo, kailangan mo yung unbreakable internet ni Bidu. Sinisigurado nila na palagi kang may backup internet connection, so kung may mangyari sa isa, safety ka pa rin. No more drop meetings, no more embarrassing reconnection status, just reliable internet 100% of the time. For organizations with growing IT needs, they can also provide managed IT solutions. Outsource your IT needs to Bidu so you can focus on the needs of your business without having to worry if your server is down. Bidu, the next level internet, worries about the technical stuff so you don't have to.
Book now for a free consultation and use our promo code to be eligible for a free video conference solution or work from home kit.
Okay, so the first thing is for the builders out there, and it's about thumb screws. Kung matagal ka na sa computer, like I remember in the early 90s, at least dito sa Pinas, wala pang thumb screws. Sobrang hassle na kailangan mo maghanap nung screwdriver, and whenever you need a screwdriver, palaging nawawala yan. You always needed a screwdriver to open up your computer because yun nga, wala pa yung thumb screws. But now, these things are super convenient. They've become mainstream, so even budget cases have them. And they're super useful because, yun, you just need to use your thumb rather than a screwdriver. Pero, pwede mo rin pala gamitin yung screwdriver sa thumb screw. I know, right? I'm an idiot. To be honest, nalaman ko lang yun this year. Mag-isa ako sa shop one time, ang sobrang higpit nung isang screw dun sa deep cool case, the Matrex 55 mesh add RGB 4F, sobrang sikip talaga, like you need the thumb of Zeus to get that thing off the case. Hindi ko talaga matanggal. So I'm trying, and I'm looking at it, and then biglang, alam mo sa ano, may tinatawag na eureka moment, na parang magka-light bulb ka na lang na, wow, wait a minute, pwede pala yung screwdriver dito sa thumb screw. And I know it's stupid, it sounds super basic. Medyo mapapaisip ka na, should I really be listening to this guy give tech advice? Because, yun nga, di niya alam na pwede pala yung screwdriver sa thumb screw. But yes, pwede pala yung screwdriver sa thumb screw. And it makes it so much easier because you don't need the thumb of Zeus to get those super, yung sobrang nakasiksik na thumb screws dun sa cases. And depending on what you're installing, let's say you're installing a new graphics card, tapos yung thumb screw yung dun sa likod ng case. And sometimes the positioning is really hard, and it makes a lot more sense to use a screwdriver rather than your thumb. Second tip, medyo technical naman, is for internet, and it's about the NAT. NAT is Network Address Translation, or basically, lahat ng information na pumapasok from the internet, pumapasok yan sa router mo. Tapos yung router mo, parang traffic cop yan. Siya magsasabi na, oh, itong data na to, pupunta ka sa browser. Itong data na to, pupunta ka sa mobile via Wi-Fi. Itong data na to para sa Discord. Itong data na to para sa game na sinistream mo. Parang ganun. Each packet of data has to go to the particular program that's requesting it, to the particular device that's requesting it, and the NAT is like the traffic cop. Siya yung nagsasabi dun sa data kung saan siya pupunta. Now, ano yung problema sa double NAT? Usually sa setups, may ISP router modem where that connects you to the internet. Kung wala to, hindi ka makakonect sa ISP mo because you need the modem function of that router. But most of us have another router na nakakabit dun sa modem router. Kasi usually, medyo olats yung modem router. Kasi libre yun. Libre na binibigay yun ng ISP mo. In fact, I've talked about an ISP router in a previous video. You can check it out to see gaano ba kaganda yung performance ng typical ISP router. But most of us have a third-party router that handles the heavy lifting of the network in your house or in your business or wherever. Siya talaga yung nagsasabi na, oh, itong data pupunta dito, etc. Problema, since both of them are routers, both of them have NAT Or sipin mo na lang, may dalawang traffic cop at paminsan, hindi tugma yung instructions ng isa't isa. Kung nagkaka-network issues ka, if you have some weird bug, if you have some weird latency in your network that you can't explain, it might be because of a double NAT problem. It's a bit technical, but how to solve it? The easiest way would be to put your modem router on bridge mode. Basically, pinapatay mo yung NAT function ng modem router mo. Sinasabi mo na lahat ng data na galing sa internet, i-pass through mo yan. Wag, kumbaga, retard na yung traffic cop ni modem router. Yung magda-traffic cop na lang, yung magda-NAT na lang, is yung third-party router mo. Problema, it's not so easy to get your modem router on a NAT. I've talked about my own troubles. Yung provider ko, Converge, yung Huawei na modem router, di ganun kadali para ilagay sa bridge mode. So, there are other options other than bridge mode. But basically, all of them boil down to forwarding your data through the modem router so that hindi na siya mag-iisip. Wala na siyang control over ano yung pumapasok, ano yung hindi. So you just have one NAT in place, which is your third-party router NAT. For the third tip, nagulat rin ako dito, to be honest, and it's shutdown versus restart for Windows 10. Common sense would tell you that if there's something wrong with your computer, let's say may driver issue ka, you know, there's just something weird going on. Kung i-shutdown mo, it should turn everything off, return it back to its zero state, kumbaga, its pristine state. For may conflict sa I.O. or things like that, shutdown should return you back to the original state. Pero sa Windows 10, hindi siya ganun. Actually, restart is the new shutdown. Sa Windows 10, which actually they started in Windows 8, yung shutdown, hindi talaga completely pinapatay yung system state. They save the kernel state, and the kernel is sort of the low-level instructions, and lahat ng mga yung mga driver instructions dun naka-store. And Windows 10 saves the kernel state on shutdown kasi gusto niya mas mabilis yung startup mo. Imbis niya ilo-load niya yun ulit lahat, isa-save niya yun para naka-load na yun pag on mo ng computer. Mas mabilis na yung startup mo. Yung problema nga, if you wanted to return to your system zero state, the pristine state, you want to restart and not shut down. Because it's the restart command that tells the computer to wipe everything, to start from the zero state, don't save anything from the kernel. And you know, it's kind of irritating kasi yun nga, common sense, inisip mo na, oh okay, may problema, may in-update ako na driver, di ba? Shutdown ko na lang kasi matutulog naman ako for the night. Pagising ko, yun, ready to go na siya. The computer will have returned to its pristine system zero state. But actually, what you want to do is to restart, set everything to zero, then everything is okay, that's when you shut down. You know, manufacturers make a big deal about yung bilis ng mga products nila. My product, my RAM can go up to 4,000 MHz. My desktop, my monitor can go up to 166 Hz, or lampas pa doon, 200, 300, whatever. Ang hilig nila magtapon ng mga numbers, higher number better. And syempre, kasi for the manufacturer, gusto nila na maisip ng consumer, maisip ng bibili na, ah oo, sobrang bilis nito, ito yung bibilin ko. But what they don't tell you is na yung ibang products, kailangan mo pa i-configure para umabot dun sa speed na yon. Common example is the RAM. Usually, yung default speed ng DDR4 is only 2,400 MHz. And yet, if you look at all of the RAM kits dun sa iba't ibang manufacturers, ang tataas ng mga speeds, 3,200, 3,600, may mga pumapalo ng 4,000. But you need to configure it properly. Pupunta ka sa XMP settings, kailangan pa i-manually set yung mga timings and things like that. So hindi siya as simple as plug and play na, uy, nakita mo yung information na, uy, itong RAM na to, 3,200 MHz. Hindi lang siya, pasok mo yan sa computer mo, 3,200 na siya. Sometimes, most of the time, some configuring, some assembly is required. Same thing with monitors. Yung usual default speed ng monitor is only 60 Hz. And yet, may nakikita kang andami, 120 Hz, 144 Hz, 166 Hz, 200, 300 Hz, parang ganun. And again, it's true na aabot yung monitor na yon sa refresh rates na yon. Pero you need to configure it manually. Usually, you need to have a driver update so that your computer knows na, oh, itong graphics card na to, kaya yung speed na yun. Pagkatapos nun, you need to detect your monitor and you need to set it properly that enabled naman yung resolution and yung refresh rate na gusto mo. Hindi naman sa nagsisinungaling yung mga manufacturers, but once you bought the item, wala na silang incentive para turuan ka na, oh, ito ah, ano, kailangan mo to gawin bago mo makita yung speed na in-advertise namin. So that's just one thing that you need to keep in mind. Para sa ibang products, kailangan mo tandaan na you need to tell it to go fast. Kumbaga, kailangan mo iset yung configuration niya na yes, takbo ka. You know, you were born to run at 3,600 megahertz, be free. Run as fast as that. So doon lang yun sa settings. Yung last na tip tungkol din sa speed or yung speed na pinapangako ng mga ISP providers. And if you watch their ads, parang sobrang ganda pakinggan, di ba? Parang 100 Mbps, 50 Mbps, fiber, 75 Mbps. And when you look at Mbps, you think megabytes per second. And what's a megabyte? Or 1,000 MB is equal to 1 gigabyte. Kung 100 Mbps connection mo, inisip mo na, grabe, in 10 seconds, maka-download na ako ng 1 gigabyte of data. But that's not the case because actually yung Mbps refers to megabits per second, hindi megabytes. Tapos yung tamang terminology dun is maliit na B. So sobrang liit lang ng difference nun. Hindi nga nagbago ni letter eh. Nagbago lang yung case. Imbis na large B, small B. Pero ang layo ng difference. Because if 1 megabyte, large B, is equal to 1,000 kilobytes, yung megabit, small B, is only 125 kilobytes or slightly less than 10% of 1 megabyte. Nakakalito, pero basically, you're getting much slower speed than 1 megabyte per second. Alayo nung 1 megabit per second versus 1 megabyte. Tapos yung nakakainis pa, hindi mo rin masisi yung mga ISP kasi usually careful sila eh. Lahat ng mga advertisements nila, palagi naka-small B yan, indicating na megabit, hindi megabyte. And yet, as a consumer, you see Mbps and you just assume that Mbps is the same regardless kung large B yan or small B. Pero, totoo, the details are in the fine print. Ang layo nung speed difference between Mbps, large B, tsaka Mbps, small B. And so, if you get a fiber line with 100 Mbps thinking that you can download 1 gigabyte worth of data in 10 seconds, that is not the case. Yun nga, kasi megabit siya imbis na megabyte. So yun, 5 sort of random tech tips. Yung iba, sobrang basic like the thumb screw. Yung iba, mas detailed like yung NAT and yung configuring your RAM. Pero, sa totoo lang, I didn't learn all of these things at the same time. Pero, nalala ko talaga, for each of these 5 things, nung nalaman ko sila, parang nagulat talaga ako na, pucha, like yung RAM, kailangan ko pala iset sa XMP or yung thumb screw. When I realized that the thumb screw can also be used alongside the screwdriver. If you have any tech tips that you think na sobrang useful for our viewers, please let us know in the comments below. I'm very clear sa Hardware Sugar na hindi naman ako super techie. I still have a lot to learn. So actually, super ako matutuwa. Like if I go through the comments and I see something na, uy, hindi ko alam yun ah. And then I can incorporate that into my own knowledge, into my own building techniques, into my own network configuration, into my own settings for my own computer. So, thanks for watching.